Hi everyone. So today we are at 13,400 feet, Loser, in Lahol Spiti. 13,000 feet. It's pretty bad. It's tough to handle the breeze. So today we're gonna do some unboxing of this modern age radio, walkie-talkie, whatever you want to call it. We got these from BRUTFORCE. Bought them. Previously we've been using the BFR-001 model from BRUTFORCE. Pretty excellent communication up to 2.5 kilometers. License free. Comes with a documentation that you can show to everyone if asked that it's a license free thing. It is a great radio. Long battery life. Currently we are standing at minus 10 degrees. We've been into this area for last 6 days. The weather has been really harsh. In the day it was close to 3 to 4 degrees. At night it was almost minus 16 at 4 a.m. So it lasted pretty well. We tried using it for more than 1.5 days. It was great. So let's do the unboxing of this new radio. We recently bought from BRUTFORCE. So again, this thing also comes with a license. Clearly shows that it's a license free model. You technically do not need any license to buy this radio or use this radio, and has been issued by Government of India, Ministry of Communication, Department of Telecommunication. So yeah, that is actually a license free radio. Good for 2.5 kilometers. So this comes with this pretty smart, neat, small walkie. And let me show you what else do I have in this. Comes with a charger, a nice flexible antenna, and a slimmer one too compared to the previous one. Boy, can you stand? Never mind. So let's attach this. What else do we have? We have the charger. We have this lanyard. If you want to use the lanyard, yeah, let's try turning it on. Okay, so now it's turned on. That's the volume button. Turn off, turn on. Again, 16 channels depending on your requirement.
7, 6, 2.
Switch to any of the channels. So it comes with a PDD button, headphone jack, mic, and the part that we love the most for all our overlanding expeditions. It's got a micro USB charging socket. Unlike the conventional radios, you do not need to carry a 220 volt docking station and charge it overnight and then again use it next day. Anytime you feel that you're running out of the battery, plug in the micro USB cable, plug it into your car jack, and yeah, it's good to roll. Another part, it's really lightweight. Compared to the older variant, the new variant is really lightweight. So yeah, I really liked it. We're doing the unboxing now. We did the testing of this when we started for this expedition. We compared both the radios. Both did the same coverage. Line of sight went all the way up to 3 kilometers. Around the mountain corners, 2, 2.5. At times it was around 1.5 to 1.8 kilometers. And that again speaks for itself. I mean, these are UHF radios. Limited power output because of the licensing issues. Yeah, but if you want to go for a license-free radio, for the modern age one, this is the pretty one. Slim, sleek, USB chargeable. I love them for my overlanding expeditions. So for all these years, doing all the expedition to all these mountains, probably to this down south, at Overlanding Rig, we'll be using these radios for our camera crew, for our entire team, and for all the members who travel with us. I hope you guys try this and you would love it.